Jamie, it's amazing to have you here with us at BFI. Can you start by just giving us a quick overview of the story that this film explores and what it was as a filmmaker, as a storyteller, that excited you about that setup?
Yeah, sure. It's the story of a divorced couple, and the universe conspires to bring them together 10 years after they divorced. And they're given this sort of wild opportunity to figure out perhaps what went wrong in the past, in the present, in order to have a brighter future. And essentially, I'm just fascinated by relationships in general, and it's a universal thing that we all go through, of course, and to explore characters that we wouldn't normally see necessarily, in terms of they are very idiosyncratic, these characters. And I wanted to see whether or not in character, via improvisation, that we would get to some kind of resolution that would be a Hollywood ending, you know. I'm not saying we did, I'm just saying that that's what the exploration was about.
In terms of those idiosyncrasies, can you tell us just a little bit more about who these two people are as individuals, and of course the wonderful cast that you got to portray them?
Absolutely, yeah. Well, yeah, I mean, Patricia, played by Hayley Bennett, I mean, just working with Hayley Bennett has been an absolute dream. She is, like, the most incredible collaborator, and so proud to have her involved in our movie, and I learned a hell of a lot working with her. And it was through the conversations in the pre-production that I have as part of the process that I realized that we were creating the kind of character that I wanted Patricia to be, that I would like to see more of. And yeah, she's, you know, she doesn't make the right choices all the time. You know, she's flawed like most of us are, and just kind of guiding her through and working together to get to that resolution was just, you know, it's just incredible. And Sam Riley, of course, I mean, he's been a hero of mine since Control, since back in 2007. And again, you know, they're just the most sensitive, courageous, fearless actors. You couldn't ask for more as an for an improv film, as an improviser, in terms of a director who does improvised films. So I mean, I'm at a loss for words, or getting tangled up in words, because it just, you know, reminiscing and thinking of how incredible they were on set and how much they gave to this project, it makes me emotional, you know. It's just I'm very lucky. I'm a very lucky filmmaker.
In terms of the decision to rely so heavily on improv, can you talk about what you think that gives both you guys as as storytellers and an audience they perhaps don't get from something that is explicitly tightly scripted and knows every direction it's going before you even start rolling?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, it's been a process that's been going on with me since, you know, 2001, when I graduated film school, working with people like Peter Greenaway, Mike Lee. I've had sessions with Ken Russell, and it was, you know, the idea of working with the actors right from the beginning, rather than sitting in a room on your own and writing a script, it just sat well with me. I'm not saying it's for everybody, but in terms of me and my voice and the way in which I like to make films, it's the thing that I just immediately found incredibly exciting. And I mean, for audiences, you're going to see way more authentic and sincere stories, because, you know, I love cinema and I love a lot of traditional films, but essentially for me, I feel like they're film theatre. You know, there's an awful lot of structure that goes into every single moment, and I feel like you're missing out on some magic there. So that's what we try to do. We try to show a bit of magic.
How magical is it to bring the film specifically here to the BFI London Film Festival? How important are these kinds of platforms?
Oh gosh, it's the first film festival I went to when I was 17 years old, as a working class lad from South Wales. My parents to pay the money for me to be able to get on the megabus and come and stay in a B&B with my pal and go and see a movie at the London Film Festival. It just blew my mind, and it made it feel possible. That you could be a British filmmaker and be involved in such an occasion where all these international filmmakers are coming to this one place. I didn't know much about London at the time. All I knew is that it was full of just absolute incredible opportunity. So London Film Festival, long may it continue and prosper. It's just a beautiful thing for independent filmmakers to be able to have this opportunity.
Can you start by telling us a little bit about who each of these characters are and the somewhat unique situation they find themselves in at the beginning of this film?
I play Idris, who is a slightly lost, not I wouldn't say has been, DJ who had a big hit in the early noughties, who he's still remixing. And he's about to prepare for his 40th birthday with his young girlfriend in a big house that's a sort of an Airbnb. And unexpectedly, a guest arrives, and it's my ex-wife.
Oh, honey, I'm home. How are you doing?
And obviously, this unexpected guest is a fascinating character in and of herself. Can you talk a little bit, Haley, about what excited you about this character and the journey you get to go on with her?
I mean, I was so excited about the opportunity of working with Jamie Adams. I'd seen some of his films and also just really excited to work with Sam and Marisa. And to come together to make this, we made the film in 6 days, which you know, you always want to go to work a little bit scared, but I didn't sleep at night. And, you know, I think that contributed to my overall neuroses in the film.
And obviously, unlike a lot of other films, this film is very improvised, it's very organic. Can you talk about the unique challenges of that and the rewards as a storyteller?
Well, usually when you arrive at work, you sort of somehow have some vague idea of what the story is going to be and what your lines are. And there was what Jamie calls a scriptment, which is a loose sort of story that he wanted to tell. And we hijacked that idea from him on day one. And we didn't really know what was going to happen. You have to completely surrender to the idea of having any vanity control. You have to trust entirely the people you're working with, right? And yourself, to not be, as you said, it's like jumping off a cliff, isn't
it? It's like being just completely naked and exposed, because you can't hide behind the writer. You can't hide behind the script. You're just kind of, you're just out there. But we made this film as a tribute to the chaos of love, and we just really hope that BFI audiences and audiences will relate to the film. I think, you know, it's a very hot topic with couples getting back together. Not that that's what happens with Idris and Patricia, but it's about kind of it's about kind of healing from past experiences.
Yeah. The concept of what love is, what counts as good love, how we fix what's been broken, can it be fixed? It's a pretty universal concept. I'm curious if going on this journey together has educated either of you in any way about what love means and what it's capable of and how we properly fix it.
I mean, I think that there's no one size fits all, and love is messy and it's painful and it takes a lot of courage. Just to keep moving forward. I mean,
yeah. Absolutely, love is the answer.
Love is the answer.
And I guess I mean,
when all else fails, sing.
Yeah.
You had seemingly a lot of fun on set. There's a lot of fun scenes. I'm curious for you guys if you each have a most precious memory from the blitz of making this film.
I have no memories at all, to be honest with you. It was like a 6-day blackout.
I absolutely concur.
And obviously, we're here all together at a film festival that, above all, is a celebration of, I guess, the power and magic of storytelling. What does that label mean to you, to be a storyteller, and why does telling stories like this matter so much in all our lives?
Wow, that's far too complex a question for me to do justice to, but you probably are better than that than me.
I mean, you know, we make films to connect with each other. I think filmmaking is about connecting, not only connecting with each other, but about connecting with audiences. And, you know, I'm here, I have this premiere tonight. I'm so proud of the film and what we accomplished in 6 days. And then tomorrow I have a film premiering called Till, which is an altogether different story and has a social message to it. So, you know, it can provoke thought, it can inform change. Storytelling is incredibly powerful, and I feel so grateful and lucky to be a part of a greater good.
What does it mean for both of you to be a part of this festival, and how important do you feel platforms like this are for the future of cinema?
for the future of cinema, I don't know. But
I think it's great to get eyes on film.
I mean, I don't think I ever thought while we were making this that I'd ever see it on a big screen.
Absolutely.
And
not.
So thank you, Tricia. And, you know, we're sorry that you're leaving the film festival, but we're incredibly grateful that something like this, that's supporting young, talented, you know, directors like Jamie, who make these things on such a limited budget with so little help.
And
so much love and talent, that they get seen by people. You know, it's brilliant.
Absolutely, what he said.